Hello and welcome to Forgeborn Hobbies. In this video, we're just kind of showing off. So a few weeks ago, I said that my next video would be an overview of my Idoneth Deepkin collection. And it's a little bit later than I wanted, but here we are. So what you can see in front of you is everything I have built and painted so far. And I'm gonna go over the design concepts, the color choices, some of the journey to get from the original paint scheme, which you can see here, to the new paint scheme I use now, which is here. And then I'm gonna talk about what's coming next for this army and what I still have to work on, hopefully what my future plans are for this army, all that kind of stuff. So I'm really excited because this is my favorite collection of all the different factions and models that I've built and painted. So we're gonna go through and just talk about what I've got. And we'll start with what I painted originally, and we'll go from there. So here we have the first unit of Reavers that I painted. Reavers are the archers for the Idoneth Deepkin. They weirdly in-game have a pretty short range, and ironically, the Nomardi that fire the bows are blind. They don't have eyes. They're born without eyes. It's weird. It's very Games Workshop-y, grim, dark, and I love it. And despite being short range and being blind, they fire a ridiculous number of arrows in game, and it actually makes it pretty effective, and I love using them. I think elves without bows just look kind of weird. So glad that they put these in. Glad that they gave them kind of a unique flavor that you don't see very often in fantasy. But this was the first unit that I painted, and you can see the skin is dark green. There's a lot of blue, there's a lot of gold. The colors don't really work, especially against the base. And the base was the first thing in this army that I really kind of realized didn't work as I was going through it. It's just really hard to see the different models against the background of the base, and you end up paying more attention to what's going on the base than you do the models themselves, and I don't like that. I really don't. So yeah, this green was my attempt to more quickly get what was supposed to be a blue green. It was supposed to look like this, which was my test model. But I had to mix a bunch of colors because I didn't have the paints on hand to get that skin tone, which ironically there's like actual GW paints that get you those exact colors. So mixing, I don't even know why I thought I needed to do that. But that's okay, whatever. I figured it out. Yeah, what really did it from changing these from green back to teal is that people thought these were goblins. Don't know why aesthetically, besides the skin tone, people thought these were goblins, but I can't have that. I can't have elves looking like goblins. That's weird. So I tried this next, once I got what I thought were the correct paints. And then they went from goblins to like, I don't know. I don't even know how to describe these, but they just didn't look right. The skin tone is too dark. I couldn't get them highlighted in a way that resolved that really well. And with the dark blue cloth, it was too much blue and gold against the brown base, and it didn't work. Also realized painting these that the gold, which you can see on the what's this guy, the soul render here, the gold just is really a lot. Someday I'm going to paint some Adeptus Custodes for 40k, and they will not be gold because I think this looks awful. I know Games Workshop gets it to look really good, but I don't like it. It looks tacky. It looks like a statue. Yeah, I'm not a fan. This gold on this Tidecaster that I kitbashed from a Silver Tower miniature, this gold works. I made it more blue and toned down, less of like gold and more of like pushing towards a bronze. And I realized that while I was trying to get bronze, I was still using gold paint, thinking I could just make it work. And basically, the lesson to learn from this is when you're painting an army and when you're coming up with a paint scheme, if you can find the paints that you can use across an army, instead of trying to mix them and just make it work, do that. You will be happier. It will be more efficient. You'll get more stuff done. And you won't feel like you're wasting your time and wasting your paints. Because if you mix paints, it's really easy to overmix, to make too much, trying to get the color right and not using all the paint in one session. And even using a wet palette, the paint will go away eventually. So really what I was learning when I was painting initially was I should have just invested in the right paints the first time. And I wish I had, but it's okay, because you can always repaint. Same thing goes for the shipwreck. This was initially painted with the Nihiloc oxide, technical paint, and then dry brushed to bring out some of the detail again. And that's what the like GW kind of like how to paint thing said, and it looked okay at the time. But then the contrast paints came out, and you can see on the Stormcast model, that's the athermatic blue contrast paint. That ends up being a lot more vibrant and better glow effect than that does. It's better. So I am going to repaint this, and I'm going to repaint all of these to match the new paint scheme. And again, some of the key details that I wanted to redo were the skin, the armor, and the bases. I also decided, I don't know if you can see it here very clearly, on this test model, the fletching on the arrows is like an off-white. That kind of looks like it was taken from like the fur of an animal, right? On these, the fletching on these arrows, and then the hair tassel on the soul render is a weird like off-white washed with blue that I kind of like panicked and did at the last second because I forgot that that's what I was going for. I don't even know why, because I kept the test model sitting out the whole time. So maybe there was a better reason at the time. I don't know, but it didn't age well. I don't like it. It looks messy, and it just kind of clashes instead of working with the model. So that was another thing I wanted to fix, was a different color for any of the tassels, any of the fletching, things like that. But yeah, this is all I have left to repaint. All of this, except some of these thralls that I just built and painted recently. These were all painted like that. So I've been spending this year, 2021, repainting, rebasing everything to match the new style, and I think it's turning out really well. So we're gonna pause for just a second, and we'll come back, and I'll show you each of these units individually. Okay, so let's start with the Reavers. I think Reavers make the best test models, partly because they were easy to find on eBay. This test model I was able to find for like $5. Didn't have to buy a whole set, was able to try out the color scheme, and I can use him as like a stand-in in games of like Warcry or D&D or whatever. But if I had messed him up, I'm not wasting a whole box of 10 models. So Really, I think if you can, and you're planning out a color scheme, you don't know how it's going to look, or maybe it's a different aesthetic than you're used to painting, go on eBay, find a test mini, even if it's not exactly the right faction. Say you're trying to test out a Chaos Space Marine for the Thousand Suns, but you know all you can find are regular Chaos Space Marines, or you want to test out Black Orcs in Age of Sigmar, but all you can find are the Space Orcs from 40K. It'll work. You can easily still test out color schemes. They're similar enough. And then you have a cool model to just have that you don't have to feel bad about wasting. So I highly recommend doing test models before you start full projects. I think it does help in the end. It helps even more if you actually put in effort to, you know, stick to your test scheme if you like it. There's really no point doing a test scheme if you're just going to completely ignore it immediately, but, you know, that's fine. We learn. And while I have these two next to each other to illustrate that, let's put him there. And then you can see side by side, these are the exact same sculpt in three different phases. And I think this really shows the difference between the color schemes. On the far left is the old scheme. The middle is the test model, and the right side is the new scheme. And the right side looks like the things I liked about the first two. So shows the progression of what I was thinking, what I wanted to do, how my techniques evolved. Even in just a couple years, I think I've learned a lot from painting that have made the new Idoneth look really, really good, especially compared to the old Idoneth. So some of those things include like the cloak, which has this really cool like texture pattern that I drew in basically with just solid lines instead of actually line highlighting or edge highlighting. You sketch in the highlight lines. So it makes the cloth look like it's a more of a rough texture and put some texture in a surface that is really kind of weirdly smooth otherwise. So you can also see here, I changed the way the backpack is painted, or the quiver. I don't want to call the backpack, whatever. You know what I mean. I kept the coral color, but I changed out the gold trim for coral, and I traded out the blue cloth for bronze. Repainted all the gold. You see on the bows here that they are gold over here, and then bronze, which clashes less with the teal and the blue. The skin is much closer to the original teal without having to mix it. I really like how the skin looks now. I'm sticking with it. It just works really well. It vibes really well. And then the base. You notice I went with a much darker base. There's some more color pop on the base, which I think works. I may have overdone it on a couple models, like where this fake floral decor stuff maybe went a little too heavy, but I like it. I think it still looks cool. Eventually, I'm going to make a display board for these guys that's going to be their coral undersea home, and it will be covered in the stuff. So hopefully, it will make it stand out. Yeah, these are the Reavers. These are the first unit I painted when I repainted the collection, because I think it just, they're fun to use. Man, archers are fun in game. In AOS 3rd edition, archers are especially good because they can now overwatch, and for their points, you get a lot more out of them as objective holders than you used to, and I recommend them. Thralls, they are, I think right now in Age of Sigmar 3rd edition, they are a little bit weak, but I think when there's more monsters on the table, they will be really, really strong because they currently have an ability that gives them higher damage output against higher wound models, which I think will be really good in the long run. It's just not great now. There's just not enough monster tag, like keyword things in the game, at least in the groups that I've played in. I'm showing this here as a unit of 20, but I normally take this as two units of 10. These are the only true battle line unit, and if you don't know what that means, you need a certain number of battle line units to have a legal list depending on the size of the game you're playing. So it's either two or three. Sometimes in the biggest games, it's like four. And you can make these and these battle line, but these are always battle line, which makes them just pretty good to have a good number of these on hand. So back here, I have a whole nother unit of 10 to add to these to either have three units of 10, you know, unit 20, unit 10, or a big unit of 30. I don't know if that's really good for these to have a unit of 30. I really probably won't do that except just to be funny at some point. But yeah, I think these are really good. And when they're mobbed up together, man, that color scheme really works. You can see all the faces. You can see that there's people, but like, this looks wild. This is not the organized spear formations of the High Elves. This is definitely the wild undersea, like ebb and flow of Sea Elves. So I just love how this looks. Let's see. So let's go over to the Achillean. These are Morsar Guard, is how I run them. This is currently my only unit. I painted these all at the same time. And it's hard to show because they're the only unit I have of these. But the idea is that every new unit I paint, the eels are gonna be a different color. So it's gonna help me tell them apart on the table easier. It's gonna make them look more natural. And less, you know, the less consistent animals look, actually the more realistic they seem. So if I have another unit that's like red, another unit that's blue, something like that, they'll still work together in the army because the riders will be the same color, the bases will be the same color, but the eels themselves are gonna look different. And honestly, I just made this pattern up. I Googled, like, I think they're called banana eels. Have this like yellow with green splotches kind of look. I thought that looked fantasy enough, so I went with it and just kind of did this by using washes and some dry brushes to get that effect. The new contrast paint, Orc Flesh, I think, was great when I was trying to touch these up when I repainted these models because I wanted that color scheme to stay the same, but I'm not the cleanest painter. I make mistakes when I paint, so touching these up with contrast paint actually was a lot quicker than the first way I did it. So that was fun. The Achillean Guard, the Morsar Guard, and the Ishlan Guard are all called Achillean Guard in the Idoneth. And this is like the tournament list kind of unit. Most people that play tournament level games are gonna use these as their battle line because they're easy to make that way. They do a ton of damage. They are useless on defense. At least these are. The Ishlan Guard version, which I don't have yet, soon. The Morsar Guard are not great defensively, but they're amazing offensively. Ishlan Guard are the opposite way around. They're just decent at best in melee as offensive units, but they have a defensive capability that is one of the best in the game for the points that you're paying. Yeah, they're fast. Ironically, they can fly because they like float on magical water. It's weird. It's wild. These are really good. I love putting them on the table. Can't wait to add more of these as well. Then we have my favorite units to play all the time. I always try to fit one of these in my list, if not both. These are the Achillean Alopexes, and these are giant sharks, ridden by dudes who have a giant ballista, crossbow, bolt thrower, whatever you want to call it. And I'm treating these the same. I got these in the same box. So I decided to paint them both as tiger sharks. If I get more of them, which I want to, I'm gonna paint them in other colors. I'm gonna go for like, some that look like great white sharks, some that look like probably bull sharks. I haven't really thought about that far ahead. And it's the same idea as the eels, that they will look more realistic if there's different kinds of color schemes on the sharks, but then they will look like part of the army because besides the shark, everything else will be painted the same. I also want to use these guys to show off. I started adding tattoos to the models, and I thought it would be really cool as like a narrative thing if they only get tattoos painted on the models if once they kill a unit. So they have to be the one that wipes out a unit, and then I'll find a way to paint some white tattoos on them. So you can see that. Oh wait, these might not have it. Yeah, the Reavers don't have it. That's because this unit of Reavers hasn't actually killed anything yet. Same with this unit of Thralls. Where's it at? Yeah, this unit of Thralls back here hasn't actually killed anything yet. That's because both of these units are kind of like brand new, and they've died too quickly. But this unit has definitely killed stuff. So you can see that I've painted some tattoos, and I tried to like I'm coming up with like a system for that. I'm trying to figure out what kind of runes might make good tattoos from the background. It's kind of a weird process. I kind of like it, but we're getting there still. So, and there's tattoos on the Morsar guard. Let me see if I can. Maybe not. Oh yeah, okay. So this is the leader of the Morsar guard. I tried to make like a lance rune. So I'm not a huge fan of how these tattoos are turning out. It's looking more like just bad war paint, but we're learning. I can go fix it if I need to. The skin's really easy to repaint and touch up. So yeah, so we have tattoos. Like I said, I always try to take at least one unit of Alapexes just because I think they're so good. They're great objective holders. They're great for like sniping out enemy characters. They can also fly. They have a ton of wounds. They're really versatile. They're not battle line, and they can never be battle line. So you always have to take, some infantry, some archers, or some cavalry. But these are just, they're really good. And I definitely am excited to paint more of them. And then we have this guy. This is definitely a centerpiece model. This is an Achillean Leviathan. It's got four riders on the back, one of whom is an Amarty who beats a drum. The drum gives like buffs to nearby units, which is cool. And then it's got two of the same bolt throwers that are on the sharks, so it puts out a lot of range damage and it hits like a truck in melee. Oh my word. This dude is good in melee. It's a ton of points. I think in the new system, it's like pushing 400 points for one of these, which is a lot. So I don't get to play with it very often because we tend to play smaller games of like 1,000 points, and 400 points out of 1,000 is a lot. You don't get to play with much if you do that. So I don't take it very often. When I do, it is fantastic. And I don't think it's died yet. I really don't. One of my friends that watches my YouTube videos can probably correct me, but I don't think it's died in game. It just has that many wounds, and it's because it's a support unit. There's so many other things around it that you have to think about as well, that you either die to the things you're not attacking, or you die to this because you're attacking other things, and it's a great distraction. Next to that, we'll do these first. Three characters. The Tidecaster and the Soul Render over here are the only two characters that are not kitbashed in some way. I love kitbashing characters. I think that the stock models for the character units in the Idoneth are fantastic. But I don't like having two of any one model. I always feel like I need to do something to change it. So after I got this one tide caster, you can see the pattern on the cloak is what I was talking about earlier. Once I got one of her, I didn't want two. So when I wanted a second tide caster, I made this one, who turned out really well, and I got to practice wet blending and all that. So it's painted way differently. I'm not gonna repaint this dude, but it is a tide caster. This is my soul scryer. This is made from a Gene Stealer Colt's Magus, I think is what it's called, with the fish from a soul render, the what's it called, the icon from, I think it's from the Nomarti. And then I built him up to be a little bit taller by using some cork on the base. He's my soul scryer. I don't have the official soul scryer model, but I'll probably get one day. This is actually an allied unit from the Lumineth Realm Lords. This is a kitbash of a soul render that I had laying around, who lost his fish and his head to the Achillean King. But I had the whole rest of the model left to do something with. So I bought a Cenari Cathalar from the Lumineth Realm Lords, glued her to his shoulder, added some other bits, and now I have my version of the Lumineth Realm Lords. Ooh. Elenaya and Elathor. That's what their names are. So Elenaya and Elathor are twins who like go around and they ally themselves with other armies that fight for order. And they bring like peace and wisdom to the realms, whatever. I decided it would be cool if instead of them being twins, what if they were like star-crossed lovers? So we have a soul render from the Idoneth and a Cenari Cathalar from the Lumineth, and they have fallen in love. The Cathalar has been banned from her people because the Lumineth and the Idoneth don't really get along, which is unfortunate because they would be great allies in game. But the Idoneth took her in. They need all the allies and friends they can get. To defend the realm of life, which is where this army is set, from the bad guys trying to invade it. So they welcomed her in, and the two of them now fight alongside the rest of this army. That model is also a ton of points. I've used it twice, and I misplayed it both times, so I'm still not sure how good it actually is supposed to be, but this is quickly becoming one of my favorite models in the collection. The more I look at it, the more I look at the textures and the way the colors work together and the composition, and just the way that, like, how easy of a kitbash it turned out to be. I really like it. Next to that is my test model for a Lumineth army that I'm planning to do in the future. I already have some of the models for it, I just haven't had a chance to actually paint them. You'll notice that the Lumineth next to an Idoneth model looks pretty similar. There's only two differences I've decided to make between my Lumineth and my Idoneth because I am planning to make like an Elven Alliance kind of collection, and I've decided that every new faction I introduce is going to have a different skin tone and a different cloth color. So for the Lumineth, they have a dark skin tone that you can probably see on the Cathalar right there on her hand, and a dark green cloth instead of a dark blue. So that way there's some things that stand out as being like, oh, this is a different like faction. But then there's some things like the cloth, trim, the armor, the coral, the any glowy bits, and the bases that are the same, no matter whether it's Idoneth, Lumineth, whatever else, F, come out, if. That way, if I put them on the table or put them on the display shelf together, they look really cohesive. And so far, it's working. When I get the Lumineth I have painted, we'll see. That'll be a while. So But even if not, this alone is, I just love this color and how it turned out. And I think elves with hammers look way cooler than people give them credit for. So, you know, if you're a Lumineth cow hammer person hater, at me. I don't care. They look cool. I want more of them. Moving on. This is my Achillean King. His name is Idoneth the Lamplighter. I threw the head from a soul render on because I thought that lamp just looked really cool. I thought it added some character. It's going to make him stand out from other Achillean Kings. In the original model, or the original paint scheme, he had gold armor, and it didn't look good with the orange and red horse. Not horse. Deep mare. They're called deep mares. So I redid that. I gave him coral colored armor instead so that he stands out from the mount, he stands out from the table, and he stands out from the rest of the army, right? They have bronze armor. He has coral armor. You can easily see, boom, even when I zoom out a lot, right? He stands out. And that's what I want. I think leaders should stand out on the table. So I'm really glad that I did that for him. I think he looks much better now. Again, redid the base, added some pop to the base, kept the deep mare the same color, kept the cloak exactly the same. I had to redo the trim from gold to bronze, but I think the bronze trim on the cloak contrasts really well without overpowering anything. So I really like that. Next to him is another ally. This is a test model I did for the Hallowed Knights Storm Chamber. So because my army comes from the Realm of Life, the Hallowed Knights are the Stormcast, Storm Host thing from that realm. And I really like the color scheme. I've always wanted to paint up a few in that scheme, and I finally just sat down and decided to do it with a Knight Venator that a friend gave me. So I gave him, you know, a bird that was green, which was painted using an old snot green or moot green, one of the two, like old Citadel paints that had mostly dried up. I was able to save it, painted the bird using that paint. And I just think it'll look really cool. I will probably never play with this model. But I do want to add some Stormcast as allies since I can take them in game. So maybe I'll add him as a character. We'll try him out and see what happens. Yeah, I'm including him here because just to show you, like, similar basing, similar paints, just choosing a couple to keep the same can make two really different kinds of models and factions look like they belong together on the table. So that's all this guy's here for. I really like him, really happy with how he turned out. And really just, I just really like how this army's turning out. I don't know, I don't know what else to say about it. Really happy with the scheme, really happy with the direction it's now going. It looks great when I take it places. People always wanna stop and look at stuff, which is my jam. You know, I get to talk to people about having off-brand or off, out-of-the-box kind of paint schemes. And yeah, it makes me want to play this army more, that it looks so cool. And I'm just really happy with it. So I'm gonna take a break for just a second, and when we come back, I'm gonna talk you through what's coming up next. Okay, so what's coming up next is this. This is all I plan to paint. For the time being, I want to focus on some other projects, like an entire Space Marine army that has no paint on it, and an entire Orc army that has no paint on it, and an entire Age of Sigmar Orc army that has no paint on it, and a Death Guard army that is only half painted, and some Kill Team, and more commissions, and some other things. So I have a Start Collecting set that I've already painted the Thralls from. I need to do the Soul Render and the Achillean Guard. I'm gonna build them as Morsar Guard. I have another box of Morsar Guard that I'm gonna build. I have the Dire Chasm set that I wanna build and paint as one, just as like its own set, so that I can play with them in Underworlds, which I love. And I think this is a really interesting warband with their mechanics in that game. So we're gonna try that out. And then I bought another set of Elithane Soul Raid for Underworlds so that I could loot the parts. And I ordered another set of one of the characters on eBay. Again, eBay for singles, great. Single miniatures, yeah, whatever, you know. And then I have some Screamers of Tzeentch that I found. And I'm going to use these to try to kitbash my own version of the Ishlane Guard, riding manta rays instead of eels. So I'm really excited for that. I'm gonna try to film it while I convert them. I've never seen anybody do it before. I think it will look great in the context of the rest of the army right there. And if it works, I'm gonna make a couple of those, but it is kind of difficult to get all the parts together. So we'll see, it's really gotta be worth it. So that's about, what is that, 3, 6, 9, 13, 14, 14 more models to build and paint. I've got 22, 23 if you count the shipwreck, models to repaint. And then this army will be at like 4,000 points or more. And I don't even have all the different units. There's still some heroes I don't have. Like the big heroes, like the Eidolon of Mathlin, I don't have that one. You know, I'll come back in the future and keep working on this. But for now, this is what I've got. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. I hope that, you know, maybe this has inspired you to try out a different style of color scheme than maybe you would have thought. I hope you see the value in doing test models and then sticking with them. If you like the video, please hit the like button, subscribe. I'm in the busy season at work that is almost through, and we're moving houses again, and should be set up for a little bit better of a workspace to get more stuff done. So hopefully you'll be able to see more YouTube content and stuff on my Instagram at Forgeborn Hobbies in the future. That's the plan anyways. So until then, let me know in the comment section what you want to see next, what you thought of this video. If you have any questions, I can always come back and do a redux and cover something I didn't, like the lore behind my army. I'm already planning to do a video on how I paint them, but I realized I haven't talked about, like, you know, what got me to the color scheme or what the narrative is. And I think, you know, that's one of the most fun parts of painting and building this army. So I'll come back to that someday. I'm going to show you how to paint the, probably one of the eels, because that gives the most, most variety of things to show you how I paint them. So there will be a video on that. I'll try to do a video on building the new Ishlane Guard. And, you know, if there's anything else you want to see, just let me know. But until then, please stay safe, wear a mask, take care of each other, and keep forging. Thank you.